So I was watching the new Call of Duty trailer, which honestly looks really cool. But as I was watching it, I noticed that they mentioned a spy named Perseus, and I found that really intriguing. So I decided to look a little further into it. In the video, they claim that Perseus was an undercover Soviet spy that had infiltrated Western intelligence. Apparently, his identity is still unknown. So to try to research this topic a little bit more, I started by searching up the video that they played in the trailer of KGB defector Yuri Bezmenov. The clip in the video is an interview that Bezmenov gave in 1984, warning the public about the steps the Soviet Union was taking to subvert the American population during the Cold War.
Ideological subversion is the slow process which we call either ideological subversion or active measures, активные мероприятия in the language of the KGB.
The Cold War was a 33-year-long war when tensions between the US and Russia were very high. Both superpowers were making weapons as fast as possible and even having proxy wars in Vietnam and Korea. It was a time of great uncertainty for the world, but the story of Perseus goes much deeper than this. To find the very first time someone had ever mentioned the codename Perseus, we would need to rewind all the way back to World War II. On the 1st of February, 1943, the US Army's Signal Intelligence Service created a small, top-secret program to intercept and decode Soviet diplomatic communications. So secret, in fact, that their discoveries remained classified for nearly half a century. The group was codenamed Venona, now known as the Venona Project. On September 2nd, 1944, Venona intercepted a message being sent from New York to Moscow. This message claims that new cover names were being used for Soviet spies based in New York. Some of these code names were Liberal, real name Julius Rosenberg, and other spies under the code names Abram, Serb, and Clemens. But most importantly, this is the first time the code name Perse or Perseus was ever mentioned. In the decades following this message, three Soviet spies were discovered to be stealing classified information from Los Alamos and sending it to the Soviet Union. Los Alamos was where the Manhattan Project was taking place, the project that oversaw the creation of the world's first atomic bomb. The spies captured at Los Alamos were Klaus Fuchs, codenamed Charles or Charles, Theodore Hall, codenamed Malad, and David Greenglass, codenamed Caliber. Although some of these spies had been captured and interrogated, even after 50 years, no one had any knowledge of the identity of the spy codenamed Perse, leading some to question whether he ever even existed. That is, until 1990. A KGB colonel, Vladimir Chikov, wrote two articles that appeared in Novoye Vreme, a Russian newspaper. In these articles, Chikov mentioned the name Perseus for the first time. All he wrote was that Perseus was an active Soviet spy. This confirmed that a spy under the codename Perseus did in fact exist, but this was all the information given, meaning that still very little was known about Perseus. The US didn't even know if the codename Perse from the message intercepted by Venona and the Perseus that Chikov mentioned were the same person. Many other KGB colonels hinted at the existence of a fourth spy at Los Alamos. Anatoly Yatskov, a Soviet consul in New York, said in a 1992 interview that someone by the codename of Perseus was a major, still-living source of information at the time. But this interview was the last bit of information we ever received regarding Perseus's identity. With no leads and only scraps of information, Perseus was forgotten about, buried alive as another government mystery. Until 1994, Lieutenant General Pavel Sudoplatov, a member of the intelligence services of the Soviet Union, published a book called Special Tasks. In it, he claims that there was no Perseus, and that it was a creation of KGB officials' imagination to protect the names of real sources. Later, in 1999, Jeremy Stone, the highly respected president of the Federation of American Scientists, or FAS for short, claimed to have found out who Perseus was. He published a book called Every Man Should Try, The Adventures of a Public Interest Activist, In it, he claims he read the articles that Vladimir Chekhov wrote back in 1991 and says, "On reading the article, I thought I realized who Perseus was because of a paragraph that Perseus had allegedly uttered 50 years before to his recruiting KGB officer. And despite the fact that this paragraph had been translated into Russian and back into English and then modified at least slightly, there was a statement and a turn of phrase that seemed to me to identify the speaker like a thumbprint." This is it. Perseus declining an offer of money for his services. "Oh no, for God's sake. I'm willing to cooperate with them for a cause, not for money. I want to dedicate my life to averting the danger of a nuclear holocaust looming over mankind, because I have just realized how real the threat of such a holocaust is, and this prompted me to counter it in the ranks of the Soviet intelligence service." Any original atomic scientist who would say that he would dedicate my life to averting the danger of a nuclear holocaust would be among FASS's original members, and if that person were still living, he would be helping us still. In the book, Stone doesn't accuse anyone by name, only referring to Perseus's real identity as Dr. X, but Stone gave just enough information for the public to figure out on their own who he was talking about, and this person was Philip Morrison. Philip Morrison was also a highly respected physicist at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology, and when he caught wind of this accusation, he sent out a statement outlining the inconsistencies in Stone's story. According to Stone, Perseus had allegedly served in the Spanish Civil War and had family in New York, but Morrison, on the other hand, hadn't served in the war and only had family in Pittsburgh. After accusing a fellow scientist, Stone responded with a letter seemingly accepting defeat, saying that he welcomes the information Morrison provided in his letter, and that he can only accept Morrison's denial that he is not Perseus. Although, while Stone had sent this letter, he never rescinded his original statement. After the book, Vladimir Chekhov, the man who first mentioned Perseus's name, confessed in 1996 that he and other KGB officials had indeed modified documents to make it seem like Perseus was real. They combined the codename Malad, a real person, with the codename Perse, creating Perseus, a fake spy to derail investigations. He even admitted that the main goal was to make the story unclear so that other countries wouldn't find out the forms and methods of the Soviet intelligence. After all the conflicting accounts of Perseus, accusations, and interviews, the CIA released a paper concluding that there was no Perseus, and that KGB officers gave fake characteristics of who Perseus was so that they could throw US intelligence off their trail. Although the real-life Soviet spy Perseus may have been proved to be a fake identity made up to throw off American intelligence, the lie was one that was created based off of real events. With two global superpowers armed to the teeth with nuclear weapons, the truth can be different from what it seems. Although officially Perseus may have been fake, there is still the small possibility that KGB officers lied on official documents to protect the ongoing intelligence work that the real Perseus was still doing. But that's pretty far-fetched, even for me. Regardless of the truth, the story of Perseus was one born at a time when the world was full of spies and secrets, truths and lies. So what's real and what isn't may not be what